All right. Greetings, friends. I am Dreyfus Anno, and welcome to just a casual stream here that I wanted to set up here. Today, I am on a sort of a new character I've created. This is a gnomish warrior by the name of Omniac. I'm going to call him Omniac Camo. And he is a boosted warrior that I made on the Wormrest Accord server. Way back in the day, I used to roleplay as a mage, and when I started playing World of Warcraft, I just got sort of a little panicked and got really used to playing warrior. So long story short, my character of Dreyfus Anno here on Wormrest Accord is a mage, so there you go. And I'll explain more about him a little bit later too, but my intention here for tonight is to actually stream and have a little bit of fun. But because we are going to be streaming here, I am wanting to make sure that I do things a little bit interesting, or at least if nothing else here, I give you a little bit of a good gold tip. Now, today's interesting thing is I'm going to be doing a little bit of a mining route here. I'm in Pandaria here down in, where is this, Karasang Wilds, and I'm going to be farming up some ghost iron and at least getting up some nuggets. Currently, right now, my mining on this character is 168, so I have a long ways to go before I get that all the way up. So with that in mind here, I do have a little Zygor Guides add-on that's going to be helping me out here a little bit. But with that, while we have Omniac farm up some ghost iron for me, I wanted to take some of this time here right now to sort of do a state of my YouTube channel thing here. I'll keep an eye on my chat room, see if anybody shows up here or something, but this is more going to just be me explaining a little bit about my channel and where it is I go from here. Now, first of all, you may notice that I don't have a webcam set up here. Currently, with where it is that I'm streaming right now, it's not really the best lighting in my room. The lights that are in my main lighting thing here, or the lights above me pretty much, are sort of giving off a yellow light, and I want to make sure that I do this properly and make it look nice. So I probably will end up setting up some nicer lights in my room so I can actually start putting in my webcam for this. But for right now, I'm not going to have a webcam set up just yet. And so getting more into my channel here, I've sort of been trying to figure out at least where does I go from... Oh, got a Sarek stone tablet there. I believe that thing vendors for a bit. Oh, there it is. Oh, for 100 gold. Nice. Okay, for my YouTube channel, my original idea was to have at least one nice machinimated video a month, and I've already had a few ideas come together. And the first one of those is, of course, my animated version of Mr. Smite's Improv. I'm up to about episode 6 right now. And I have another one in the works right now, but I just sort of forgot about it, and I need to actually get it back set up. And that was sort of going to be my bread and butter of having at least one video out a month. And then also, alongside that, so Overwatch had come out, what was it, like 2 months ago, I think. And I don't just want to do just a let's play of Overwatch, of me just playing the game. I still want to make it a little bit interesting, and I'm sort of half tempted to just play it as just myself. But at least I want to make it a little bit interesting. And you may not necessarily see it right here, right now, but in my YouTube channel, I'll put a link down in my actual description when I actually upload this to YouTube. where I have my characters of Dreyfus and Kabataka and Asmundarius actually going through and playing the first game of Overwatch. And so it's officially as if they've they're just playing it for the first time, while technically waiting for Legion and the Burning Legion to come. So I sort of had this idea with Overwatch to actually do something I like to call the quest for the play of the game, where I have this goal of wanting to get a play of the game on every single character in Overwatch, and then see if we can make it a little bit interesting and, like, with, say, Tracer's Bomb, knock out at least four people, or, say, with Zenyatta, get, like, over 10,000 healing or something. Sort of just ideas, and I'm just rambling a little bit. But, essentially, I found Overwatch to be so fun. This sort of goes back to my Autism Awareness Month thing that I had done back in April, that if I play a game that I really, really like, then I will just perseverate on it, or in other words, just be so focused on it that I'll forget everything else. So I've usually just kept my playing of Overwatch to maybe once or twice a week, maybe a little bit more if I'm just really stressed out, because it's a very fun stress reliever. So I'm going to have another sort of machinimated episode 2 of Quest for the Play of the Game coming out pretty soon. I should also mention here, and I'm going to be mentioning this here in a few minutes too, that the WoW WoW model viewer actually stopped working after the 7.0 patch actually came out. Get rid of that. So it's sort of this weird thing with the WoW model viewer where sometimes it'll be up, sometimes it'll be down, and you usually have to make do with everything you have. So what I'm going to be doing with episode 2 is something a little bit different. I won't go into too many details just right here, right now. But I hate it when I get feared like this. I have the escape artist, and I feel like I should be able to use that, but anyways. So with Overwatch, I don't want to necessarily just do a let's play of it, because I've already seen a lot of other YouTubers actually do this. I sort of follow another channel by the name of Unit Lost in Stylosa. He has a lot of good content that has been a little bit helpful learning all the classes and everything, so shout out to him for what it's worth. So Overwatch, that'll be coming out here. Another video idea that I did have was something called Dynamic Return. I was inspired a lot by the Machinimator Oxhorn way back in the day. Of course, you have Oxhorn and Staghorn and more too. So I believe the undead elite speaking rogue, I think he was, and they. And Oxhorn had created this sort of mini-series by the name of the Dynamic Action Team, which consisted of characters from Team Fortress 2. And in that series, what happens is that it's consisted of a medic, a heavy, and a spy, which apparently are just three colleagues playing together. They say in the series that they're not really friends, but they just play games together. And the medic is, for some reason, convinced of not wanting to be a button-mashing killer and decides to be a role player, and he has this weird asphyxiation with wood. And if any of you have actually seen the Dynamic Action Team, let's see, he has sort of this catchphrase of "Wood, buy my wood," and it's sort of this parody of a really old TV show called Sliders, which is sort of a what-if time travel thing. And so they go from Team Fortress 2 into World of Warcraft. I believe they went into the game Spore. Then they went to Diablo 2. and then finally ending up in the Left 4 Dead game when it just had barely come out at the time. Now, I don't really know all of the details for the Dynamic Action Team, but apparently it had ended at about episode 5 or 6. Now, what happened is that when they all got into the Left 4 Dead area, of the course, the stereotypical zombie apocalypse thing happening, Francois finds, or sorry, the medic, his name is Francois, finds the heavy, but the spy is nowhere to be seen, and I won't give any spoilers, but it just ends on a cliffhanger, and then the season just stops. So what my idea is, I already have episode 1 on my channel already, which I'll put down in the description here as well. It'll be something where Asmodarius and Kabatica create this portal into the TF2 world, and they're hired here by a mysterious contact, where the mysterious contact will want to actually bring them back. I won't go into too many details about that, but it's sort of going to be my own sort of official spin-off of, unofficial spin-off, I should say, of the series, because I thought it was really, really interesting. I just thought it was so cool to see other video games mix TF2 mixing with WoW and things like that. And it was just such a bummer that that did not work out, and it just ended at that episode 5. So it's sort of going to be a mini series in and of itself. Well, I'll probably only have like 5 or 6 episodes. And then when the mini series actually ends, it'll sort of branch out into other ideas. So I'll be able to maybe make some other shorts and create some other misadventures for all of my characters too. And it goes without saying that I still have a lot to get set up, obviously. So that's one other thing too that I've been wanting to do. Now that I think about it too, if any of you actually know me, I'm actually a really big fan of Power Rangers, and I've watched every single season, even if it is considered cheesy and not really high quality or anything. And one of my big pipe dreams that I have been wanting to actually do is create sort of my own unofficial Power Rangers series, where I just create a my own team and some own monsters and things like that, etc. And I've been wanting to sort of branch out into After Effects and either Maya or 3ds Max. So in regards to this here, this sort of gave me the idea of maybe building my own monsters, having them invade Azeroth, and then having sort of do a tongue-in-cheek thing of Power Rangers, and seeing if I can't make my own series and have it just rival the last series that's out here, Dino Thunder, I believe it is, or Dino Charge, that's what it is. And just have a little bit of fun with that too. So a lot of my videos probably will have a lot of other references like that in this case too. And so next up on my itinerary here, got Mr. Smite's Improv, Animated, Overwatch, Power Rangers, music videos. Now, way back in about 2008, my first video that I ever put on my YouTube channel was a really weird music video that I made called Techno Rocker Xanoic Mode. And that was my first ever attempt at actually making a music video. And I don't really know what my original ideas for that were, but just I can remember that my original ideas for wanting to make that music video were just having characters dance to a specific beat. When the beat of the song happens, you see the tauren stomping on the ground, or me kicking in the air in a dragon stomp sort of fashion. But a lot of my ideas were really, really weird, and I was sort of going into it not really knowing what I wanted, and I didn't really know how to create a good story at the time. So that was my first music video. There was also Ding, and there was also Million Miles from Home when I made that for my my friend at the time, Nananea. I have a couple of other ideas that I'm trying to flesh out a little bit here too. So I'm probably rambling here a little bit, but I do sort of want to create some other parody songs and see if I can't make them really fun and interesting, sort of like WoW's version of Weird Al Yankovic, but in my own very specific way. And I will mention this here too, I will never swear in any of my content. If any of you ever see a video of me maybe playing with anybody else here who does swear here or anything, that's sort of one of those learning experiences I've sort of had to deal with when setting up a YouTube channel to begin with. And so, yes, you're probably going to find some other content with other people who may have more saltier language than I do, but for me, in my content, I will never swear. And I will be saying this a lot. I'll be selective of it, but I am going to say I will never swear in my content. So if that's something that you're not going to be a fan of, if you prefer it, this channel will not be for you. So with that said, still focusing on my whole music video idea, usually I like to figure out interesting ways to make these videos, and on my commute to work and sometimes when I was in college, I would listen to music videos or listen to songs that I found really interesting and sort of imagine and storyboard in my head, this is really interesting, what if I did this, and etc. I have this idea of wanting to sort of branch out from my Dynamic Return series and make a music video of a couple of other Minecraft YouTubers that I follow a bit. Like there's Bajan Canadian, there's Sky Does Minecraft a little bit. I follow them too. They can be really funny sometimes, and yeah, they do swear a lot too. And it's a weird thing that I'm still trying to get used to, but it's still something that I probably will never get used to. So that's another idea that I've wanted to actually... where's this other one? Oh, there it is. Okay. So a couple of other ones too that sort of just have fun. And there was another music video I'd made in the past. It was the Million Miles from Home one, where I had featured a lot of other WoW creators that were... comic creators or other machinimators or other webcomic creators, and that was probably one of my bigger items to date, and that was pretty tough for what it was. I am still learning a little bit, so I am trying to actually figure out here a little bit still, again, where it is I go. So there's a couple of ideas that I am still working on. And then the next thing on my docket here too that I do want to mention is Patreon. Now, when I was doing my Mr. Smite's improv shows, I usually do an out of character reference where I say, I have now set up, I'm going to be setting up a Patreon where I can get rewards and set up a tier system and everything. And I would say, I would set that up when I got 100 subscribers. Now, I realize too that I officially hit 100 subscribers maybe about 3 or 4 months ago, and I realize that I still have not created an actual Patreon. And so going back to the whole thing of I'm still figuring out a lot of stuff and seeing where it is I go from here, I realize as I'm recording this live stream that I don't necessarily... I haven't gotten that Patreon set up, and sort of my thinking with that was this, that I want to set this up where I can actually add to my own workload and figuring out, can I make 2-3 videos a month and then also make an epic screenshot of myself and a supporter or a Patreon actually fighting against Gul'dan or something. or maybe for a $5 tier, have it so I just send somebody a nifty line of me rhyming or rapping or just saying, this is Dreyfus Zano from Mr. Smite's Improv, and you've reached this person at this number, and just make it be really funny. Probably what I'm going to be ending up doing is setting it up where my first original goals is probably going to be a free tier where just you can just offer your support and just say, good job, keep it going, and a good old slap on the back or something for me. A $1 tier where you can, if you do that, you can have one of your machinimated characters or a character show up in one of my shows, maybe as a laughing extra in a Mr. Smite's Improv or something else where you could just walk on stage, and then I would acknowledge that usually in the credits. A $5 tier where maybe I would do something called the epic song and maybe improvise a song for you for your phone or something and just say, brand it as Dreyfus Zano, Mr. Smite's Improv, etc. There a $10 tier where I have a little bit of knowledge in Photoshop, and I can make some desktop wallpapers of maybe your character being in an epic pose or punching Deathwing in the face as a dwarf or something like that. Or maybe even as a $5 tier, going sort of back to the $1 one, is where you can actually maybe have a spoken line in one of my machinimas, and then I would just have to improvise a little bit and just work around you. I want to have at least a $10 tier and a $20 tier, and seeing as now I've now actually set up this streaming here on Twitch, this will be something else I'll get into here eventually, is I would like to actually set up a stream where you can see me behind the scenes actually editing my stuff and everything, but I am still learning about this OBS software and everything, and still just figuring out how it works and getting up a nice overlay for my Twitch, and still just getting everything again set up. And then a $20 stream or a $20 thing too. And maybe just have it no more as $20 and just see where that goes for right now. So I'm going to do that. And my initial goal as the first checkpoint is I'd like to raise $1,000 for myself and have it so I'd like to have this be my full-time job, where I create funny content, maybe do a gold guide once in a while, maybe share some interesting tips that I found out here and everything. Let's minimize this over here. And just see where that goes. And again, I say that full well realizing that in the last 2 months, maybe I have only uploaded maybe one or two videos to the channel, and maybe a handful of my Mr. Smite's Improv streams through my Twitch channel itself. And, oh, I don't think I wrote this down, but... I'll be getting to this here a little bit more. I'm going to put down this as a note. Okay. I'll get to that here in just a moment. Okay. So, Patreon. I am still figuring out how to actually get that set up, so it is still going to be coming. I want to make sure that if I set it up right, that... not only am I adding to my workload, but I'm working smarter and harder at the same time. All right, so Patreon, setting up tiers and checkpoints. Okay, so now sort of moving away from my channel for just a bit. I've had sort of a bigger idea for my channel that I've wanted to set up for some time too. I've wanted to do something that I like to call a machinima renaissance, where I noticed here that after Oxhorn and a couple of other WoW makers sort of stopped doing their things, there wasn't a lot of machinima out there other than there's Red versus Blue, and now that I think about it, I'm not really familiar with other machinima out there other than Red versus Blue. I'm sure there may actually be that, but I'd like to actually see other WoW creators try to come out of the word work and see if we can't make a couple of more Oxhorns or some quest for the Chronicles of the Annoying Quest. That was sort of a series I unofficially followed, and yeah, that series was definitely interesting. It was really funny, but incredibly salty language again too, and I won't get too much into that, at least for right now. And I'd like to actually set something up where I'd like to collaborate with other YouTubers out there and try to at least expand a little bit and try to get my name out there. So what my idea is for this Machinima Renaissance is I feel like with the skill set that I have, I can make some tutorials for the WoW model viewer when it does actually get all set up and everything, and it's ready for Legion, and it's passed its little thing with the pre-patch and everything. Once that gets set back up, I can do an actual tutorial of going through the WoW model viewer, setting it up, and then just showing this is how you animate, this is how you turn a character, this is how I usually do it in my own funny way, of course, and then just take it from there, going into maybe the Windows Movie Maker or the Sony Vegas, Adobe Premiere, and then just make it very, very simple and maybe show a couple of tips along the way. As an interesting tip here, I should mention that when Oxhorn got started, at least as far as what I remember, his first videos were actually just him recording with Fraps, the screen capture video, and also he just used the Windows Movie Maker too. Very, very low end, very, very, yeah, just low end. So maybe setting something up here where for me, I have a lot of stuff that I can set up here to make it look nice. So I want to at least make sure here that even though that I, as of this moment, I only have 101 subscribers on my channel, I can set something up to still make it look nice while I'm still improving my skills. So setting up a tutorial for the WoW model viewer, and then how to just create a very basic machinima. And then eventually branching off of that, I want to actually set up something too where maybe we can, with my tutorials, have it so maybe we get in contact with singers and other music makers like Charm or Gigi or something like that, and grab some of their songs that they have and actually pair them up with machinimators, and maybe hold like a little fun contest where maybe 1 month take a song from Charm. She's a WoW singer that does a lot of other fun stuff. She has a very nice singing voice, and she does a lot of other games too, I believe Guild Wars, and I'm really blanking right now, but she is pretty familiar with doing some WoW centric stuff, and just getting maybe 3 or 4 people together and having them compete a little bit and seeing who can make the best rendition of, say, the Alex Straza song, or, man, I'm really bad at remembering song names here, but just how well can they actually represent what it is the original song creator made, and then have it where maybe get a panel of judges and the song creator themselves, and the song creator chooses their favorite song, and at least at the same time, that creator gets maybe 3 or 4 music videos and gets their name known a little bit. So setting up singers with other rappers, with machinimators, because I like seeing music videos and seeing where they actually go. I do try once in a while, and I may even just enter this in here myself as just, this is sort of the example of what it is you're looking for. So we can set something up like that. It's not so bad right now with my ghost iron. 33 nuggets. Got just about a stack. It's sort of been interesting here with playing a boosted character. This is the... probably the second or third... excuse me. Second or third character I've boosted, other than some Pandaren. And I never really set it up with veteran accounts or anything. So, just needing to level up some Ghost Iron. Alright, moving on from that, the Machinima Renaissance. Okay, Twitch. So, I have a Twitch stream set up here, referred to as twitch.tv/DryfusXano, and I am actually still figuring out how this all works and how to set up the best streams for what it is I want to do. So first of all, what it is that I have been doing, you'll probably see this on my channel here as well, is probably turn off Outfitter here for a moment to not have that spam there. For my Twitch channel, what it is that I'm doing is actually streaming my little improv show that I do every Friday and Saturday on Warmrest Accord called Mr. Smite's Improv. And this is something that I created where I really like improvising, and I felt like on Warmrest Accord, that is a really good place to actually just role play and actually stand out as well. So I probably improvised about a couple of months. I started, I want to say, mid to late October of last year, and that anniversary is coming up here fairly soon. I probably spent about a good 3 or 4 months just improvising by myself and just getting a name for myself. And it wasn't until maybe a couple of months later, and it was a bit of a challenge in and of itself, where I met my good friend Swordinary, and then there was also Vileona, there was Kuroi, Aladra, and I've actually made some pretty good friends with that group. We've had a lot of fun actually improvising, and improvising for me is a real stress relief, because in the job that I work at, it's a very, very stress-inducing environment. I won't get into a lot of details with it, but just suffice it to say, I'm glad to be home when 5:36 o'clock rolls around. So with Mr. Smite's Improv, what it is that I've set up here is that maybe once a week, I will stream one of my shows and then not stream the other one, depending on the audience participation. Sort of as an internal rule that I've set up is for my shows, I'd like to at least have 10 people actually be in the audience to make things interesting. There have been a handful of times where my shows have had maybe one or two people, and at least for me, that to me is not really interesting, because if they don't give us any good suggestions, then that's not really entertaining for the group I'm trying to reach out to. So the more people that come to my Mr. Smite's Improv shows, I can't even English today, means more jokes that we can make, and maybe a new running gag or a new hashtag that we create. And then that just means more hilarity all around. We do something referred to as hashtags, where we may create a new inside joke for all of us. One really popular one is with our character Aladra, we created one where just a joke is, "Hi, I'm Aladra." And it's sort of one of those things where you have to be there to see it, but it can be pretty funny when that does happen. So going back to my Patreon thing too, I was sort of thinking maybe as one of those checkpoints too, that if I can reach $1,000 in my Patreon, then maybe I'll start streaming every one of my shows. But I'm still keeping an eye on how many people I get on my shows on a weekly basis, and at least getting these all up. One other thing too with Mr. Smite's Improv is one thing I'm going to do is actually compile together a best of thing, where in all of these streams, maybe compile the best jokes that were provided, and then just see where that goes from there. I mean, plenty of times when we have our shows, we have just the best jokes and we have the best banter going around, and maybe compiling those all together from the shows that we had, our first show being in Northrend when I started streaming, just see if that's something that's interesting. Throat's getting dry a bit. Hold on. Gatorade. Okay. So, my plan here for right now is to stream Mr. Smite's Improv once a month, and maybe a little bit more should I figure out how to set up my Patreon and how to actually do everything here. So I have that, the best of, and the last thing that I've written down here on my docket that I've written is, because I've actually set up my little Twitch thing, and with time, once I improve and get a little bit better and everything, is I can now actually stream my Autism Awareness Month event that I've now, that has now been in its third year, I believe. I'll have to look at my pictures that I've had. For those of you that don't know, at least if you haven't seen my Autism Awareness Month thing that I did last April, is that I am on the autism spectrum. And sort of standing out here too, I wanted to do something on the Wormrest Accord server to make it stand out and actually do something a little bit interesting to reach out to anybody else on the spectrum. So something that I had done was actually gather a lot of different people from the Horde and the Alliance and dress them up in red, blue, and yellow robes and dresses and create a giant awareness ribbon. If this actually goes up on YouTube a little bit later, I'll see if I can actually find the three images from the three previous ones, I believe. I'm going to have to do a little bit better job of actually keeping track of that. So I've done that a couple of times here, and a couple of people have actually recognized me from doing that. And now that that's the thing here, my idea now is to actually stream this and actually get a lot of people into my streams and just see everything, so Horde and Alliance can again get together. With my character too, I'm not really the biggest on fighting, but I will if I have to. And so he's sort of this character, not Omniac right here, but with Dreyfusano, I've set it up where he's sort of a lawful good character with a little bit of lawful neutral to him. And so I feel like both in character and out of character, he's fulfilling that, where bringing the Horde and the Alliance together can, at least for one thing, see eye to eye, so we're not just fighting each other and just for the Horde, for the Alliance. And that pretty much covers everything that I've wanted to say here, but I think for at least right now, I do want to say thank you to everyone here who's still subscribed to me on my YouTube channel, and there is going to come that point where I will get to 1 million subscribers. It's not going to be this year, I know that much, but I do have that goal of wanting to actually get that silver and that gold play button, and heck, maybe even that diamond play button if I get incredibly popular, but at least when it comes down to it, I want to make sure that if I ever do become popular and you see me out on the street, just I want to be just the chillest quote-unquote celebrity, knock on my desk with wood and everything. I want to be reachable and approachable, and just there's a whole lot of good that I can do here with my YouTube channel. And again, I've said this a couple of times already in the stream that there's still a lot that I am learning, and I'm actually learning from a lot of other different YouTubers how they do things, and seeing if I can't just yes and what it is that they do and see if I can't improve myself a little bit myself. So, trying to think of anything else that I would want to say here. I'm probably going to actually finish up this lap. Got a loft error there. And I think I ended right over here, I think. So, wondering how long we've been going for. About 42 minutes, so not too bad. So I think I'm going to end up my little thing right here and just call it a quick stream for tonight. And I realize that I am just talking to myself. I'm going crazy. I am going to be popular. How unprofessional. I'm coughing. So yeah, just to recap, webcam not really set up right now because doesn't really look the best in my room, but I will be getting that set up. My current plan for right now is I'm getting one nice machinimated video out a month, which is going to be either my continuing series of Mr. Smite's Improv as animated and machinimated, which I may actually add some of my cast members in that when the WoW model viewer actually gets fixed. And also, just lost my train of thought here. One other thing I wanted to mention here too is that if you see a lot of my videos, you may notice that Dreyfus is still using the standard definition character. The reason that I actually did that is sort of two reasons. One is because the WoW model viewer goes up and down so often, I use a lot of different animations, and so because it is currently down here at the moment as of the stream, I would have to actually use all of the animations that I've used or that I have made, and have to maybe go back through a Techno Rocker one or my Ding one to actually pull up some animations of me walking or Kabatica walking, etc. So there's that, and sort of an in-character reason is, I'll sort of give you a little bit of a spoiler here, is that when my Dynamic Return series ends, I'll go from the standard definition character into the actual high definition character. And I think probably what I'll end up doing too is probably taking some time and actually animating all of my characters together, so that should the WoW model viewer actually go down again, I'll have that little bank of animations to pull from, so I can at least do videos. So, Machinimated Mr. Smite's Improv, we have Machinimated Overwatch. I'll put that link down in the description of my first episode. So, I could use a lot of feedback to make this a really good thing. And my first one was okay for what it was. Episode 2 will be coming around here fairly shortly once I figure out what it is I want to do with it. So Dynamic Return, that'll be about a 5-6 episode miniseries where I won't necessarily get into a lot of spoilers, but we'll see if my characters of Dreyfus and Kabatica and Asmund can figure out where the dynamic action team set up, and can they get those three characters back into the TF2 world. So, and I think too, with my Power Rangers segment that I mentioned, is I want to learn 3DS Max. I want to learn Maya a little bit and see if I can't actually do some modeling and some rendering and some animating and texturing and everything. And just have this be where I myself created everything. And I say that full well knowing that I'm actually not the best at creating my own music. I usually just find other instrumentals online and everything, so it would be one of those things of maybe I reach out to somebody to have them build a nice Power Rangers-esque song for me. Okay, so Power Rangers, music video ideas. If there are other parodies you'd like to see, I'm game to actually trying them, but also at the same time, if we're talking about an Eminem song or some R&B song like that. I'm probably not going to be game machinimating it unless I can do it in such a way where I take out the innuendos, the swear words, and make it reach to sort of a broader audience. So my brain usually likes to think of a lot of ideas a mile a minute, and I have a bunch of sketchbooks that I've written down a lot of things, which I probably have to find here in my room and see if I can to get a lot of those other ideas back together. So I have a lot of music videos, and one very special one that I want to be releasing here by the end of the year. But again, I need to see when the WoW model viewer actually comes back up and get back into that groove and everything. I should say. So let's say two very special music videos that I'll want to be releasing here fairly shortly. So now, and again, going into that machinima renaissance. It may be a little bit weird referring it to as a machinima renaissance per se, because there is still machinima going out there, but I'd like to see more of it. Even if it is just Windows Movie Maker and it's just people talking, maybe that's a good stepping point. And just encouraging other people to do comedies and dramas and things like that too. So I'm going to be planning on sometime here in the near future, whenever WoW Model Viewer actually does get all set up and get all fixed, arrange that and figure out a way to do just a very simple, basic machinima in both. See if there is a Windows Movie Maker for Windows 10, and also for Sony Vegas, for Premiere, and then to show you a little bit about my own personal pipeline and how I actually do my own editings myself, and see if I can share with you a few tips myself. So there are tutorials, and then eventually branching off of that, I want to actually set something up where we get a lot of singers and other content creators, and see if we can't just get a lot more music videos made in the future. So that's my alarm. Something I do with my phone too is I set alarms on the hour to help me figure out what time it is, so I just sort of stay on track for myself, and it's a pretty nifty thing to do. So setting up I'm going to call this my machinima renaissance, setting up singers and rappers with machinimators, and setting up that semi-often competition where we have a month of selecting somebody's song, and then they volunteer to judge to the songs, and the end result being we have four or five music videos, and somebody may walk away with like a Steam gift card or maybe a Blizzard pet or something. There's that. So in the future here, I'm going to be streaming my Mr. Smite's Improv maybe once or twice a month. Maybe more here, depending on how many people actually get in my audience. I should also mention here too that I'm not going to share any spoilers, but the new Stormwind Park actually was created in Stormwind, and so there is this new fountain in the middle, and there's this very mysterious patch of land there. I went over there a little bit to roleplay, and I noticed that there was this big patch of land, and to me, that felt like it was one of those, it was a really good stage. And so I may actually have a couple of my Mr. Smite's Improv streams there and see if that actually works. And I'm really hoping that there's a way to actually phase in and out the spoilers. Again, not going to say what it is. And see if we can actually use that as another stage besides the gazebo we normally use. Now, I pulled up my map here. In the Blasted Lands, there's a dragon around here where you can talk to that will actually shift you in and out of the WOD, Warlords of Draenor content for the Netherguard Keep. Again, I won't get into many spoilers. And I'm hoping there's like an NPC you can talk to that can shift you in and out of that. So streaming Mr. Smite's Improv maybe once or twice a month. And I'm going to be working on actually doing a best of segments of the last, I believe I have 3 or 4 streams to look through, and see if we can't make some other giggles there too. And in the future here, when the next April comes around, I want to actually stream my next Autism Awareness Month and actually see if I can make it a little bit bigger. I should mention here too, and this is going to be the last thing that I mentioned before actually wrapping up, is that in the month of March, my job sort of got a little bit stressful. I won't go into a lot of details here, but something had happened where a lot of my plans just went kaput, and I wasn't able to do a lot of the stuff I wanted to do. And I did quote-unquote cheat a little bit, where my vlog every day in April was actually recorded in about a 2-day time frame to make sure that I actually got 30 days out there with for every day in April. So is it cheating? Is it not? I'm not going to necessarily lose any sleep over it, but I got 30 days out there. So I think with all of that wrapping up here, streaming future Autism Awareness Months, I'd like to actually set up some other events in the month of April itself. Something that I did here, I think it was last year during the last Thanksgiving event, I actually set up a little carnival in the town of Westfall and got a couple of guilds together, and we sort of went through Westfall and everything and provided some aid to the characters, and then sort of had it where we would go up to a hill and then there have a couple of carnival games and have it sort of be in character where kids could come and dunk Mr. Smite and things like that. And I'm gonna really try my hardest to get something set up here again in the future, so that I want to make the next Autism Awareness Month even better than this one. And then of course wrapping it up with maybe the live stream of all the events and everything with my, again, another ribbon. Okay, so ending our little thing here, little path and everything, looks like I ended up with 59 Ghost Iron Nuggets, 47 Ghost Iron Ore, not too bad. I'll see if I can sell that on the auction house and see if I can make a little bit of money. All right, so the next time I do this stream, I'm going to find another instance or raid to go through and sort of just mix this up a little bit. So with that, let's get off our mount here. Goodbye that Pandaren. So for that, I am Dreyfusano, and for Omniac, I wish to thank you again for viewing this very brief stream here of, again, my YouTube channel and everything that I mentioned. So I hope to see you at my next Mr. Smite's Improv. And until next time, like I said in my Autism Awareness Month, be you, be yourself. All right, take care. Bye-bye.